Good morning. This is a day that we have designated to introduce and to also install our officers for 2019. I want to assure you that one of the most important things someone said to me, they said, if you think you're leading and you look behind you and there's no one following, then you're not really leading, you're just walking. And so I took that to heart. And when you see how many people have committed themselves to the work of the ministry of this church, you will know that I am not out here by myself, that it takes an army of people to fulfill the vision that God has imparted to us for this generation. For those of you who will be visiting with us today, each year we go through a day-long seminar to train and prepare our leaders for what they may confront during the coming year. This year, our theme was Leadership Under Fire, and we studied the life and the journey of Moses, because we know that his leadership was under fire the entire way, and we did that in order to glean some lessons of leadership that we can apply as we endeavor to go through, knowing that we're going to run into criticism and condemnation and challenges of our faith and challenges of our patience as we go forward. But with God, we will all make it to the promised land. And so I want to introduce our leaders to you, and then we will collectively pray for them as a church and install them for 2019. Let's say amen. 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 You can go ahead and give God some praise. You know, each time, every year, whenever we've had a guest presenter to come for our leadership seminar, they are amazed by how many people will come out to talk about leadership and commit themselves to do the work of ministry during the coming year. They said this is just unheard of in many churches, even churches three times this size. They have a much smaller group of people who are willing to work. And this is not everyone. These are the leaders. There's a whole army of people behind each of them making the vision come to pass. And so we are now ready to install them for this year. The great task thrust upon these officers who stand before us cannot be done by them alone, but by the help of God. We pray that they will be able to serve their officers well, but their best effort will fail without the wholehearted and consistent cooperation of all the members of this church. And so I say to those who are preparing to be installed, for as much as you have been selected to serve as officers and leaders, and you have declared before God and man your willingness to serve your officers well, do you wholeheartedly promise, and with the consistent cooperation of all the members of this church, that you will perform all the responsibilities of your assignment? The answer is, I do. Do you promise to honor God and your church in your services, in your behavior and conduct? I do. And to the members of this congregation, will you accept and receive these brothers and sisters as your duly elected officers? Do you promise to give them respect, honor, encouragement, and cooperation to which their offices entitle them? And if so, will you signify the same by standing and saying amen? Amen. Let's do it all together. Amen. Amen. All right. Then I declare by the will of God and this congregation, you are to serve as duly selected officers. May the rich blessings of God's grace be upon you, and may you enjoy the confidence and support of your brothers and sisters. Now let us unite our hearts in prayer of a consecration for you. Let us bow our heads. Oh, Father, the giver of every good and perfect gift, we come before you at this moment to give praise to your name, to invoke blessings upon these that stand before you and these good people today. We ask that you would approve the choices that we have made and bless them with a faith as great as the measure of their task. We grant that you would pour out your Holy Spirit upon them, that they, being sent to serve, may be committed to a great and divinely larger cause in the kingdom. Consecrate them to the work and service of a high Christian calling and keep them inspired with your present Spirit. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. God bless you all. Thank you. Thank you.